Hello everyone, this is teacher Ahmed Dejghani from the Palestinian schools in Doha, Qatar. Today I will explain to you Unit 8 grammar. Let's get started. Page 60. Grammar, giving instructions and advice. Exercise 1. Read the sentences. Write the instructions and advice in the table. Here you have some sentences and the table. You should put the instructions here and the advices here. This is an example. The first instruction here is put on a hat. Let's read the sentences one by one. Put on a hat. This is an instruction like this. It started with a verb. You should take water with you. What do you think? Is this an instruction? The instructions are like the orders. Is it here an order or an advice? You should take water with you. Next. Read the instructions first. Does it seem order or an advice? What do you feel? What do you think? Read the instructions first. Next, you should take water and something to eat. Is this sentence an order, an advice? What do you think? Is it an instruction or an order or an advice? Don't be late. This also. Next, you should return before sunset. Next, take your boots. Don't hurt your feet. Okay, I'll give you some time. Fill the table here. Finished? It's easy, right? Let's check. The first one here, read the instructions first. Read. It is an instruction, of course. Next, don't be late. The third one, take your boots. Don't hurt your feet. Let us hear, my students. All the instructions started with a verb. Read, don't, take. Okay, let's move to the next part, the advice. The first one, you should take water with you. It is an advice. Next, you should take water and something to eat. Next, you should return before sunset. Exercise 2, page 60. Read and choose the correct words to complete the rules. Okay, now you are going to read first, then to choose what to choose the correct words to complete the rules. 1. To express instructions. You can use to express an instruction or instructions. What do you need to use? What can you use? The verb or should? I think it's very clear because you did exercise one and understood the lesson or understood the rule. 2. To express advice, we can use what? Advice need a verb or should? What do you think? 3. We form negative instructions with what? Always when you hear or read the word negative, negative means the verb not. The verb not must be available. Okay. Think and choose the correct answers. Finished? Let's check. 1. To express instructions, we can use, of course, a verb, because instructions start or start with a verb. Next. To express advice, we can use, of course, should. And finally, we form negative instructions. Negative instructions with what? With don't and verb. Don't play, don't run, don't eat too much, don't speak loudly, etc. Exercise 3. Write the words in the correct order. Here you have four sentences. Okay, you need to order the words in each sentence so that the sentence looks right. Let's first read. One, put boots you on. Four, should the hike. The next one is phone, mobile, you, a, take, should. Next, other, help, each. And finally, four, we, look, should, a, hospital. Okay, I'll give you some time, then we will check the answers together. Finished, my students? Let's check. Number one, you should put on boots for the hike. Very good. Two, you should take a mobile phone. Right. The third one, help each other. Correct. Finally, number four, we should look for a hospital. Good. We should look for a hospital. Nice. Now exercise 4, page 60, read and think. Then choose the correct words to complete the rules. Let's read these sentences one by one and think of them. These are reflexive pronouns. Reflexive pronouns, return to the subject. I hurt myself. The subject here is I. I goes with myself. I'm talking about myself. I, myself. I hurt myself. Enjoy yourself. You are talking here with someone. The reflexive pronoun is yourself. He cut himself. Himself goes with he. She hit herself. She, herself. Herself for the feminine subject. The dog, or it, hurt itself. Itself here with cats, dogs, not with people. Next. We are helping ourselves. We are talking about ourselves, plural. We are helping ourselves. We takes ourselves. Next, enjoy yourselves, plural here, not singular. Enjoy yourselves. You are talking with many people, not someone, not singular. They are teaching themselves, means each other. They are teaching themselves. Okay. We can phone each other. We want to see each other again. Yes, let's now check the correct words from this table. Since you understood the sentences here, you can easily choose the correct words to complete the rule. One, we add self to, look here, self, self, self. We add self to I, you, he, she, it. Can we say I self, you self, okay, or to my, your, him, her, and it. What do you think? Myself or I self? Yourself or yourself? It is very clear here from the sentences. What do you think? Of course, my, your, him, her, it, itself, herself, myself, etc. We add selves, selves plural, like here. We add selves to we, they, or our, them, very clearly. Can we say we selves? Themselves or ourselves, themselves? Of course, ourselves and themselves. Next, we use words like himself when someone does something to himself or to someone else. We use words like himself, like here, he cut himself. We use words like himself when someone does something to himself or to someone else. What do you think? Of course, himself. He cut himself. Yes. We use each other when someone does something to each other, like the example above. Here, we can phone each other. We want to see each other. So, what do you think? We use other. We use each other. When someone does something to himself or to someone else, of course to someone else. Like the example, we can phone each other, we can teach each other, we can play with each other, we can advise each other, etc. Is it clear? Nice. Let's move to the next slide. Read and circle the correct word. Here we have 5 sentences with 2 options to each sentence. Read, think, and choose the correct option. Are you ready? Let's start. 1. Who gave you or yourself that? 2. We looked at us or at ourselves in the photo. 3. She taught herself or she taught each other to dance. What do you think? She taught what? Okay, 4. We talked to ourselves or we talked to each other on the phone. On the phone, you talk to yourself or to another one. What do you think? Okay. 4. Tell the group leader if someone hurts himself or yourself. This exercise is very nice, very easy, especially if you understood exercise 4. Think and choose the correct answers. Finished? Let's check. 1. Who gave you, of course, who gave you that hat? Who gave you that hat? 2. We looked at ourselves. We looked at ourselves in the photo. Ourselves returned to we. 3. She taught to dance. She taught what? Herself. She taught herself to dance. And don't forget that her returns to she. Yes. We talked to on the phone. We talked to what? Each other. 5. Tell the group leader if someone hurts what? Hurts himself. Very nice. Let's now look at this rule. Okay, grammar, giving instructions and advice. We explained how to make an instruction and how to make advice. To give instructions, we can use what? We can use the verb. To give instructions, you need to start with a verb. We form negative instructions with don't and the verb, like the examples before. And to express advice, we can use should. Should comes with advice. Okay, let's look here also. Grammar, self and each other. I think you understood this very clearly. We add self to my, your, his, her, it. Myself, yourself, hisself, herself, itself, and selves to the plural pronouns. Ourselves, themselves. Okay. We use words ending in self, selves, when someone does something to himself or herself. Okay? Again, we use words ending with self, selves, when someone does something to himself or to herself. Okay, we use each other, when someone does something to someone else, not for himself, to someone else. Okay, my students, thanks for watching, and I hope that you enjoyed and understood the lessons with all its rules very clearly. Teacher Ahmed Al-Ghaimi was with you. See you soon in a new lesson.